Welcome to our third tutorial. This time I'm going to show you how to use macros and subroutines in practice. Subroutines in practice have special syntax. In the main block, the call of the subroutine is done via the keyword GoSub. The definition of the subroutine is done after the undo of the main block, and there must be a return at the end of the subroutine implementation. We can use practice macros to pass arguments from the caller to the callee. We can also use them to pass the result from the callee to the caller. The practice macros can be local, private, or global. If no attribute is used, the macro type will be local by default. For this tutorial, we are using Trace32 PowerView for ARM with the released version of February 2014. So let's start. The first thing that I need to do is to load the script that I have already prepared for this video. All the training scripts can be found under T32 Demo Training. For the practice trainings, click on Practice. Now select script macros and subroutines.cmm. So here is our script. Press on the debug button to debug the practice script. Now select the CPU, then do a system up. We can step or go over these two lines. Alternatively, we can select the line just after the system up. Right click and tell the debugger to go till this line. This way, all the commands preceding the selected line will be executed. The following block opens some windows. As shown in previous tutorials, the WinPause command is used to predefine the position of a window. So this is the pmacro window. It shows the program listing and it contains the list of the local and global practice macros. The data dump window shows the content of the memory at a defined address. And finally, here is the area window to show the messages. This line contains what we call a practice macro, which is a placeholder for a sequence of characters. Macros can be global, local, or private. Global macros are visible everywhere and are not erased when the declaring block or file ends. Whereas, the local macros exist inside the whole file containing the declaration. Unlike the private macros, which are visible only in the declaring block. In the second block, there is a subroutine called verify checksum. A subroutine is in fact a portion of code meant to be used more than once. It can be called with optional parameters. In practice, the call of a subroutine is done with GoSub. If we press on the step button, we enter inside the subroutine. Please note that in practice, you should never put a space before the definition of the subroutine, and it must be followed by a colon. Let's now go more in details with this block. The parameters given in the subroutine call are now passed as entries. Data.sum determines the memory checksum using CRC32 format. If the data.sum function returns the expected value, result will be true, which is the case now. Otherwise, the result is false. This line prints that the checksum is okay. Now we set some different value in the memory. We did this on purpose in order to cause a checksum error. Let's enter to the verify checksum subroutine. The data.sum is now not equal to the expected result. This way, the value returned by the subroutine is false, and we will print an error saying that the second checksum failed. This is the end of our tutorial. Thank you for watching and see you next time.